Almond consumption dates back to biblical times. They're even mentioned in the Old Testament. Around 100 AD, the ancient Romans showered newlyweds with almonds. This ritual came from the belief that they increased fertility. But today, it's the nutritional value of almonds that keeps us coming back for more. Almonds are a guilt-free snack. They're full of vitamins, minerals, and protein. More than 80% of the world's almonds come from California, where growing conditions are ideal. Upon arrival at a processing facility, the almonds are still encased in leathery hulls. They flow through equipment that combs out debris. The next machine, called a destoner, targets any rocks. Air blows through it to separate the lighter almonds from the stones. The almonds travel between a rubber roller and belt. This spins off the hulls and releases the almonds. The operator periodically examines the de-hulled almonds. Vibrating decks with slots sort the almonds by size. The system also shakes off hull material and vacuums it up. The almonds head to a gravity table for finer separation. The spent hulls and other material float to one side, while heavier contaminants float to the other. The in-shell almonds tumble down channels. Cameras examine the shells for imperfections and look for contaminants. Then a blast of compressed air knocks them out of the flow. These are some of the contaminants that have been removed. At another facility, machinery will now grade the almonds according to the condition of their shells. Once again, the almonds fall through the open air, and a computerized camera scans them for broken shells and other flaws. A compressed air gun then knocks the flawed almonds out of the mix. The almonds bounce along a vibrating grid, and any kernels or missed shell fragments fall through. Finally, people sort through the almonds and reject any that don't have perfect shells. They also toss out any contaminants the mechanized sorting system missed. Some buyers will pay a premium for the best nuts. The almonds with broken shells will have the shells removed. These raw almonds are also sorted by size. They flow onto a vibrating conveyor. Further along, the conveyor has holes. The smaller almonds fall through these holes and into bins. The larger almonds continue forward. These larger kernels are worth more and will be sold separately from the smaller ones. As with the in-shell almonds, good looks are important. A camera photographs the cascading almond kernels and a computer scans the images. The system knocks the less than perfect almonds out of the production stream. Next, the almonds head towards a robot. Along the way, another camera sends the images to a computer scanner. This one has been programmed to find chips, scratches, and even small broken bits. The computer sends the coordinates of the damaged almonds to the robot. The robot then finds them and plucks them out of the mix. A human inspector now picks out any imperfect almonds that the robotic system missed. Their flaws are just superficial. They still taste the same, so these almonds will be processed into chocolate bars, almond butter or milk, baked goods, and cereals. The perfect almond kernels travel forward. Just ahead, machinery moves cardboard boxes into an open position on a packaging carousel. Sprayers apply glue to the bottom flaps and pushers close them, sealing the boxes. The almonds now arrive at a scale. It releases them into the boxes in approximately 50-pound batches. These big boxes of almonds will be shipped to other facilities to be processed into other products. Smaller amounts will be packaged for consumer use. A snack anyone can crack or enjoy pre-cracked. Almonds are a natural and nutritious choice. No wonder they're consumed by the handful.